City Point Church started 20 years ago, and as a church, we've accomplished a lot. From starting right here in Brisbane to now having many locations worldwide, we've seen so many lives impacted for good and for good. And although our influence has grown, the mission and heartbeat of what we do has not. Meeting great people from our church all across the world and being able to experience firsthand the great works and impact we're having overseas in the She Rescue Home and other great organizations. I've experienced firsthand the global reach of Faith, Love, Hope and the impact our generosity has as a church. From the person I sit next to on Sundays to someone on the opposite side of the world, City Point is invested in making a difference. I have no doubt that we here at City Point are influencing the world for good and for God.
What a year it's been since our last Faith, Love and Hope offering. The end of 2019, as normal. Beginning of 2020, as normal. Then a COVID pandemic hits the world, closes churches down in Australia and across the globe. We are thrust into a whole new era of online church, and what an incredible job the team has done to get us there as well. Now we're able to have a global reach, and here we are back ready for Faith, Love, Hope 2020. As Lee and I reflect over the last year, all I can say is thank you, church, for your commitment, your involvement, what you've done. It's just been amazing. And to all the location pastors and your teams at every location, well done to every one of you. So many dramatic things have happened that we had no idea to be ready for, and you've just moved so well. We're on fire. Things are happening. The church is still doing great things in the community. We've gone to an online service now with global outreach, and it's just been amazing. So, hey, John, tell us about what's going on with our online services.
Yeah, well, creativity, I think, has always been one of the great hallmarks of our church. But probably in this season, I've never been more inspired by our creative team. You know, when we heard the news, hey, physical church is closed, we've got a few days, create online church, the team just rose to the occasion. And all the filmmakers, all the web designers, our set designers, script writers, everyone just kind of, all right, let's get together and let's make this thing. And really amazing. I think our team not only just facilitating great church services, but in fact, world-class service experiences for people to share the good news with, not only in our homes, but with people unchurched. Pretty remarkable.
Yeah, I loved seeing the whole church come together for online services in a whole new way. And we saw testimonies come through of people giving their hearts to Christ for the first time. Also, people working Sundays, able to go to church online. This has been a fantastic season for the life of the church.
Well, as a matter of fact, online church has gone so well, we're going to continue on with it. It gives us a global reach. We're going to invest lots of money into it and make it a significant part of our outreach to the world, not just Australia, so it's going to be great. I mean, this pandemic's affected the whole world. Ben, how did it go over there in New Zealand, this whole shutdown thing with you over there?
We were so grateful for the online church because we were in full lockdown for 6 weeks, could only leave the house for essentials. So your phone became your best ministry tool alongside with your Bible. And we were making regular phone calls, doing daily devotions, and doing whatever we could with hampers and food vouchers to be a blessing in the community.
Yeah, now you're open.
Yes, we've been open for a few months, and it's pretty well life back as normal. So it's great.
We are all so envious and jealous of you all over there. Well done. Dana, tell us about Nashville. Again, we've reopened there as well as a church. So what's happening there?
opening up, it's been a journey. You know, we had to open up to all kinds of rules, social distancing. We have more hand sanitizer in the church now than ever before. But it's been nice being able to reconnect. It looks a little bit differently, but being able to see one another's face in person besides on camera has been so uplifting for the ones who come.
And what's been great about this season is even though we couldn't gather as the church, we were still being the church. And in a season where people are doing it so hard, people out of jobs, things going well, business is not happening properly, and here we are on the ground helping people, caring for them, feeding them and looking after them. It's just amazing. Hey, Pastor Tim, tell us what's happening in the marketplace.
Yeah, Pastor Mark, just incredible the timing, the fact that we've renovated for 6 months this old building, and the very week of COVID starting is when we opened up. And from that point, we just saw people coming and needing help. That very first week, 200 people just knocking on the door saying, hey, we lost our jobs. We have got nothing. Can you please give us food? Since then, we've given away 340,000 kilos of fruit, vegetables, bread to just families in need, families that have just come, not all lost their jobs. Some of them have just been in poverty for a long period of time, come just accessing food through us, which is absolutely incredible. And people have noticed. You've thrown to us, Pastor Mark, to unmistakably influencing our world for good and for God. And we're doing that, and people are noticing. Our council has been down a number of times to see what's happening at Marketplace. We've had Anastasia Palaszczuk's office come down, and not just come down, they gave us money as well and just help in what we're doing there. Just last week, we had our federal member come through, and he really walked around Marketplace with his jaw on the ground, just stunned at the incredible things that we're doing and the amount of people that we're influencing through this incredible COVID season. And he is just blown away by the fact that we are making such a difference.
I remember when Pastor Mark and Lee came back from the United States, you were in quarantine for 14 days. And I think Pastor Lee went into vision mode, dream mode, and we had an existing vintage store here. And then we transitioned that into a marketplace, similar to what you were just talking about, Tim. And I love the vision that comes out of this house, and also how fluid we are as an organisation, in that we'll be able to move from one entity to another entity. And it's just been such an incredible blessing, the Brisbane Marketplace, to our local community. And we've also partnered with the West Marketplace, and I think we've distributed like over 1,800 free food hampers to our communities right across this great city of Brisbane, which is remarkable.
So Mother's Day looked really different this year. Ivory Project Mother's Day packs were delivered to local hospitals to place value on and celebrate disadvantaged new mums in our community. So we thought it was especially important to support these disadvantaged mums in this time.
We actually had our local high school reach out to us as well, because during the lockdown, they'd lost touch with around about a third of their students and were genuinely really worried about it. And so they asked for our help. And so we were able to put together some hampers so that we could support the school in going in and checking on the students' welfare. And once we realised how hard the teachers were working, a lot of the parents got together and thought, how can we do something to bless these guys? And so we put some packages and some hampers together to take directly to the teachers, just to thank them for how they were serving our city through this time as well.
Also, we did the same with our uni students. We gave out 1,000 ministry packs to them for the ones that were in their dorms.
So yeah, here at City Point, Northern Colorado, man, the church really came alive during COVID and the quarantine that really awakened. We partnered with Betagumba Restaurant and to feed people during this time. And we fed over 8,000 people, over 1,500 prayer requests. I mean, salvations and miracles right there in the streets of downtown Loveland. But also, we raised over $60,000 worth of grants to be a part of this outreach, and we have actually more funds available to us if we want it. We're astonished, and the cool thing is the outreach is going to continue, and we're starting to touch hospitals and schools and really reach into our community.
During the last few months, I've loved being in contact with our location pastors. And I remember a telephone call I had with Pastor Bojida from Bulgaria as well. And he was just talking about the great need that was in that nation, especially back in the Gypsy community. And he was talking about they were delivering food hampers into that region. And he didn't ask for any finance, but I remember getting off that telephone call and talking to Pastor Mark and saying, how can we help? And I know because of the generosity through Faith, Love, Hope offering is that we were able to transfer funds immediately. So not only do we feed the poor, we also reach the world globally with our music. And so excited over the last couple of months, Pastor Chad, the team, have been in conversation with Capitol Records, surprisingly, which are based in Nashville, Tennessee, of all places. Now we have a location there. And proud to announce that City Point Worship has signed with Capitol Records, one of the largest record labels in the world. And so we are so excited about our worship going right across the globe.
And look at all the incredible things we have accomplished as a church. This is because of you, your generosity, your commitment. And it's not the end. We've got a whole new season ahead of us. We're going to completely change the world. Jesus' name will be made famous. So God bless. Thank you so much. Yeah.